Students, today we will discuss about another concept of light that is called dispersion. What is dispersion of light? When light passes through a prism, it splits into its constituent colors. In case of a white light, it is split into 7 colors. In case of a light consisting of suppose 3 colors, it will get divided into 3 colors. So the phenomenon of splitting of light into its constituent colors is known as dispersion of light. So let us have a diagram to understand what is dispersion. Let us say this is a prism. This is the principal section of the prism that we'll discuss later on. When a ray of light strikes the surface, refracting surface, it splits into 7 colors. From here, this is violet, and the end of the spectrum is red. So in between, you will have different colors. So in between, you will have different colors. There are 7 colors. So this phenomenon of splitting of light into its constituent colors is known as dispersion. So you can see that the white light, it was supposed to go like this, but now it bends, it splits and is divided into many colors, and finally here there is a refraction. Again there is a refraction. So refractions takes place at two places, one at this face and another at this face. So twice refraction happens. So here white light is now, you can see here this is divided into 7 colors. It is regular. So the color which is bent the most is the violet, and which is bent the least is red. So if I allow combination of these lights also, which is obviously the white light, then they are separated into different colors. Now this angle, this is the violet one and this is the original direction. This angle is called the angle of from here, I'll say, from here to this line. Finally, this is the emergent ray and this is the initial direction. This angle is called the angle of deviation for the violet ray, and for this red, this angle is called angle of deviation for red color. In between, you will have the angle of deviation of other colors. So for yellow is considered to be the mean color, so his deviation will be from the middle. So this deviation, this angle is called angle of deviation for yellow color. This is the mean deviation of the color. Now, so the angle of deviation is maximum for violet, minimum for red. The speed, if you think of the speed of the colors in different in this sections of the prism, when different color passes through the prism, then the speed of the violet color is least and the speed of the red color is maximum. So the speed of red is more than the speed of violet. The refractive index of the refractive index of the red is less than the refractive index of the violet. The deviation of the red is less than the deviation, angle of deviation for the violet. So these are the things you have to remember. Okay, now as far as the wavelength is concerned, the frequency will remain same, the wavelength is concerned. So the wavelength of violet is less than wavelength of red, because the velocity is frequency into wavelength, because frequency is constant. So the direct relation, the wavelength of violet, you can see here the velocity of violet here, and the velocity of red is more. So therefore the wavelength of red will be more and the wavelength of violet will be less. So it moves faster, the red light moves faster and the violet light moves the least, because of its high refractive index it moves very slowly. So this is what is known as dispersion. So any it is not about prism, any other medium which can split the light, white light say, into its colors, that also will be called dispersive medium. So dispersive medium is one which disperses the light. Maybe the light consists of more than two colors, or more than two colors, then that is the dispersive media. And sometimes the prism is acting like a dispersive medium, and sometimes you will have a rainbow happening, that is also disperses dispersion occurs, and that is also known as the suspended water droplets. It also acts as a dispersive medium, so it disperses the white light into its seven colors so that we see the rainbow. So this is what is known as dispersion. So basically dispersion is to see whatever light falls on the medium, that we see it into different, it separates into its constituent colors of which it, the light is made up of. Okay, thank you.